Everyone, it's Nadia from Yarn Utopia. Today we're making this adorable corn amigurumi. This is so simple and so much fun to make. I'll get into the supplies we need and then we'll get into making this cute little piece here. So the yarns I'm using is actually Red Heart Super Saver yarns. Here's a label of one of the types of yarns I'm using. Red Heart Super Saver, and we're not going to need a whole lot. This piece can fit in the palm of my hand, so it's really tiny. I don't actually even have yardage for how much yarn we're going to use. It's a scrap project. So the main color of the corn, I'm using the color lemon. You can use any yellow color you have lying around. And then I'm using a regular green. I think this is Patty Green of Red Heart Super Saver Yarns for the outside shell of this, the leaf part here. Yep, this is detachable as well, so it's really cute. And this part is this green color. Then you're going to need just a little tiny bit of white yarn for the eyes. I used some felt. I cut some felt out of this, just this brown. Dark brown piece of felt for the eyes and the mouth. And then I used this Aran or off-white color for the hair of my corn here. So just a little tiny bit of that. And then you're also going to need an E-sized crochet hook, which is 3.5 millimeters. There you go. So you can see that. So this is the size hook we're going to use to crochet this piece. And I used some tacky glue to glue down the felt. I used some polyfill to, oh, that's behind my lamp here, sorry. I used some polyfill to stuff my corn, and we are using a scissor and a yarn needle to cut the yarn, sew in some ends, and sew these pieces together. So these pieces, we are making two halves of the corn piece and then sewing those together. We're making three of these leaf pieces and then sewing them halfway together, and then we are sewing on these two eyes and attaching this just tuft of hair. So those are all the pieces. Now for measuring, this piece is quite small. It is about 13 centimeters, okay, long, which is about 5 inches long. Okay, so that's how long this piece is. It's very small and very cute, and it's fun to like crochet some food. And yeah, the eyes and the mouth are optional, so you don't really have to use those, but this is what it looks like. So let's get into it. Before we begin, I do have to mention there are links in the description of this video. So there's a link to the blog where you'll get the written pattern, the free written pattern on my website, yarnutopia.com. You'll also get the links to the Facebook and Instagram. So I would absolutely love if you made this and shared your work. I would absolutely love to see if you what you come up with and how you make yours and share your work. So hashtag Yarn Utopias when you share your work on Instagram. You can also, follow me everywhere. All those links are in the description of this video. And lastly, I have to say a big, huge thank you to my dad, Fuad Azmat, for taking the time to make this video with us. He's our videographer, editor, and photographer for all of our videos. So make sure you subscribe to my channel here on YouTube so you can get that update on when he posts our next video. So now let's just get started and make this cute little corn amigurumi. Let's start out with the green, and we are going to make a slip knot. So put your short end over your long end, then fold that down over your long end and pull that through, and then pull tight, and there's your slip knot. You can insert your hook and we can start. Let's start out by chaining two. So yarn over and pull through one and two. And then in the second chain from the hook, we are going to put one single crochet. So the loop on the hook doesn't count as a chain, so count one and two. That's the second chain from the hook. We're going to go in there, then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, that is a single crochet. Now we're going to chain one here, and then we're going to turn this around. Okay, so you're looking at your single crochet like this. We're going to turn this, okay, around just like that. And in that single crochet stitch, which is right here, we are going to put two single crochets. So go into that single crochet stitch just like that, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. So that's one single crochet. Go back into that same stitch, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. So now we have two single crochets on row two. Going up to row three, we're going to chain up one and turn this around. And we are going to put two single crochets in each stitch across. So we are going to put two single crochets in this first single crochet right here. One and two. And then in this next one right here, we're going to put two in there as well. So that's three and four. So there's going to be four single crochets on row three. So chain up one, turn your work around. And now going on to row four, we are just going to put one single crochet in each stitch. So one, here's two, next stitch three, and the next stitch is four. Okay, so row four has four stitches. Going on to row five, we're going to chain up one and turn our work around. And now we're going to put two single crochets in this very first stitch right here. So put two single crochets in there, one and two. And then we're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches. So one and one. And then this last stitch on this row gets two single crochets. So one and two. So at the end of row five, you will have six single crochets. Okay, then chain up one and turn your work around. Going on to row six, we are only going to put one single crochet in each stitch across. So again, row six has six single crochets. Just single crochet across. Then we are going to chain up one, go on to row seven, so turn your work around. And row seven, we are going to increase. So we are going to put a single two single crochets in this first stitch, one and two, and then one single crochet in the next four stitches, one, two, three, and four. And then this very last stitch on this row gets two single crochets for a total of eight single crochets on row seven. So now chain up one, turn your work around, going on to rows 8 through 15. Okay, so rows 8 through 15 are just putting one single crochet in each stitch across. Then chain one, turn your work, and put one single crochet in each stitch across for rows 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So I'm just going to do that. That's a repeat pattern, just putting one single crochet in each stitch across, no increasing here, just chain one, turn your work. Now I'm going on to row nine, and I'm just putting one single crochet in each stitch. And I'm going to do that until I finish row 15, and when I finish row 15, I'll meet you up and we will start decreasing. Alright, I just finished row 15, so this is what your piece should look like, just like this. Okay, so now we are going to go on to row 16. We're going to decrease, so chain up one and turn your work around. And we are going to single crochet two together now. So we are going to go into this first stitch here, yarn over and pull through, and then go into this next stitch right here, yarn over and pull that through. And then we have three loops on the hook. We're going to yarn over and pull through those three loops. Okay, so that's single crochets those two stitches into one, and that's a decrease. Now we're going to single crochet in the next four stitches, just a regular single crochet. So one, two, three, and four. And there's two stitches left. We're going to single crochet those two together. So go into this next one here, yarn over, pull through, go into the next one, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops on the hook, just like that. So at the end of row 16, you will have six single crochets across. So now chain one, turn the work around. We're going on to row 17 now. Just single crochet in each stitch for a total of six stitches for row 17. One, two, three, 4, 5, and 6. Then chain 1 and turn your work. Going on to row 18, we are going to decrease again. So single crochet these first two together. This first one here, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops. Now we're going to single crochet a regular single crochet in the next stitch and in the next stitch. And then we're going to single crochet these last two stitches together. So go in, yarn over, pull through, go into the last stitch here, yarn over, pull that through, yarn over and pull through all three loops on your hook. And so you have 4 stitches on row 18. So now we can chain 1, turn our work around, and for row 19, we are going to single crochet across for a total of 4 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then chain 1 and turn your work around. Going on to row 20, we are going to single crochet these two together. And then we're going to single crochet these two together. So in row 20, you should have 2 stitches. Then chain 1, turn your work around, 1 stitch left. Just single crochet these last 2 stitches together so that you'll only have 1 stitch on row 21. So now we can fasten this off. So I just chained 1 there. We're going to cut our yarn quite long because we're going to use that for sewing. And then we're going to continue to pull that all the way through and then pull that tight. Okay, just like that. So this is what your piece should look like. So now I need you to make 2 more. So 3 of these in total. So I have already made 2 of these off camera here. So these all look the same. Okay, so if you need to, rewind this and make 2 more of these. So you have 3 of these in total. Once you have 3 of these made, grab your yellow yarn and we can start making the corn. All right, so I have my yellow here. We're going to make a slip knot and we're going to make the corn. So put your short end over your long end, fold that down, and then pull this through and then pull tight. Okay, insert your hook. All right, and we can start. So let's start out by chaining 2. So yarn over and pull through 1 and 2. And just like the green part, we're going to put a single crochet in that second chain from the hook. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Now we're going to chain 1 and turn that around. And then we're going to put 2 single crochets in that single crochet we just made. So go into that single crochet, then yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Go back into that same stitch, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. So now on row 2, we have 2 single crochets. Now we're going to chain up 1 and turn our work around again. And we are going to put 2 single crochets in each stitch. So go into this first stitch here, put 2 single crochets in there. And then in the next stitch right here, put 2 single crochets. Okay. Now going on to row 4, we're going to chain 1 and turn our work. And now we're going to put 1 puff stitch in each stitch across. So a puff stitch, we are going to yarn over. Now this part you want to do quite loosely here. So yarn over, go into the very first stitch. Okay. Yarn over and pull through. So now we have 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, go back into the same stitch, yarn over and pull through. So now we have 5 loops on the hook, yarn over again and go back into that same stitch, yarn over and pull through. So now we have 7 loops on our hook and we're going to yarn over and pull through all 7 of those loops, just like that. And then we're going to chain 1 to secure that puff stitch. And we're going to do that in each stitch across. So yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, 5 loops on the hook, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, 7 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through, all 7 loops, and then chain 1. Okay, puff stitch in the next stitch. Okay, make sure you chain 1 after that, and then puff stitch in the last stitch. So you should have 4 puff stitches in total on this row. Okay, and then after that last puff stitch, make sure you chain 1. Turn your work around. We can go on to row 5 here. So now you can see here, it looks like we actually have 8 stitches, but these chain 1 spaces are not going to be counted as anything. So you can see our chain 1 right here. So we're going to go into the stitch right here. Okay, I don't know if you can really actually see this chain 1, but if you turn your work this way, you'll see there's our chain 1. So we're turning my work here. We're not working in the chain 1. We're working in the puff stitch right here, and we're going to put 2 single crochets in there. So 1 and 2. Okay, then we're going to skip this chain 1 right here and put 1 single crochet in this puff stitch here. Then we're going to skip over this chain 1 right here and put a single crochet in this puff stitch right here. And we're going to skip this chain 1 space right here, and we're going to go and put a single crochet in this last stitch. And this last stitch is actually going to get 2. So there's 1, and go it back in for another 1. Just like that. So there should be 6 single crochets in this row 5 here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So now chain 1, turn your work around. Okay. And for rows 6 through 10, we are going to puff stitch in each stitch. But I'll show you row 6 first, and then I'll show you row 7. So, because it's a little bit different, because we're working in single crochets here. So in this first single crochet right here, we're going to make that puff stitch. So yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through. And then again, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through. There are 7 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through all 7 loops, and then chain 1. Yarn over, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, going back into that same stitch, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over again and go back in, yarn over and pull through. And then yarn over and pull through all 7 loops on the hook. If you can fit it, there we go, and then chain 1. Okay, so then puff stitch in this next stitch and chain 1. Okay, I have 3 puffs to go. Chain 1. Make sure you chain 1 between each puff stitch and after your last puff stitch as well. Alright, so I just finished my last one here, chained 1. So now I have 6 puff stitches in total. So I chained that 1, I'm going to turn my work around, and instead of single crocheting across here, I'm actually just going to puff stitch across. So where do I puff stitch? We're going to work in the actual stitches, okay? So not the chain 1. So we just chained 1 right here. So we're going to turn our work, we're not working in that chain 1. We're going to yarn over and go into the puff stitch right here. Yarn over and pull through, yarn over, go back in, yarn over and pull through, and again, yarn over and go in, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through all 7 loops and chain 1. Yarn over, skip this stitch, it looks like a stitch right here, but it's actually that chain 1. We're going to go into the puff stitch actually right here, okay? So go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all 7 loops on your hook, and then chain 1. Okay, so again, yarn over, skip this chain one right here, go into the actual stitch right here, and make a puff stitch. Then chain one, yarn over, skip this chain one space, and go into this puff stitch right here, and make a puff stitch. Then chain one, skip this chain one space right here, go into this puff stitch, and make a puff stitch in there. Oops. Okay. And then, oopsie. There we go. Chain one. Okay, I need one more here. We have this chain one right here. We have the puff stitch right there. So yarn over, go into that last stitch, and make your last puff stitch. Then chain one, turn your work around. Okay, so now I'm going on to row eight here. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep. Row 8, 9, and 10, I'm going to do off camera. It is a repeat of row 7. So I'm just going to work a puff stitch in each puff stitch across for a total of 6. Make sure you chain one in between your puff stitches. And then keep doing that until you finish row 10. And once I finish row 10, I will meet you up and we'll go on to row 11 together. Alright, so I just finished row 10 here. So this is what your piece should look like. A bunch of puff stitches looking like corn. So now we can go on to row 11. I chained one here at the end of my last puff on row 10. So now I'm turning this around. And we're going to single crochet two together. But what we're going to do, you can see again, we're not working in that chain one there. Okay, we're going to work in the puff stitch right here. Okay, we're going to go in there, then yarn over and pull through, then skip over this chain one and go into the next puff stitch right here, and then yarn over and pull that through. So now we have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops, just like that. Then we're going to skip this chain one right here, and we're going to go into this next puff stitch and single crochet in there. Oopsie, yep, there we go. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, and pull through 2. Then we're going to skip this chain one, and we're going to single crochet into this puff stitch right here. And then we're going to skip this chain one, and we're going to go into this puff stitch right here. We're going to yarn over and pull through, but go into the last puff stitch right here. So skip this chain one and go into the last puff stitch right here, yarn over and pull that through. So now we have 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops just like that. So now on row 11, you should have 4 stitches once again. So now we can chain one and turn our work, and we are going to puff stitch across these 4 stitches. So yarn over, go into this first single crochet, yarn over and pull through, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over and go in, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 7 loops on your hook, and then chain one, and puff stitch in the next stitch, and then chain one, puff stitch in the next stitch. I'm going a little faster now because we know how to do puff stitches. Chain one and then puff stitch in the last stitch. So you should have 4 puff stitches at the end of row 12 here. So now we can chain one, turn the work around, and we are going to single crochet 2 together. So remember, we're not working in this chain one right here. Okay, we're going to go into the puff stitch right there. Yarn over and pull through, skip this chain one right here and go into the next puff stitch right there, yarn over and pull that through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops, then skip this chain one right here and go into this puff stitch, yarn over, pull through, skip this chain one right there and go into the last puff stitch, yarn over and pull that through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And then chain one. So at the end of row 13, you should just have 2 stitches. And now at the end of row 14, we're only going to have 1 stitch because we're going to single crochet these 2 stitches together. just like that. And now we can fasten this off. So chain one, cut your yarn quite long for sewing. And pull that all the way through. And then pull that tight. Okay, so there is one half of the corn. This is what it will look like, kind of like a little hammock right now. It's kind of cute. So now I need you to rewind this and make another one exactly like this. So I have one done off camera already. So this is what my other one looks like. So we have both of these finished. So now what we're going to do is sew these together like this. Okay, half and half, just like that. And then we are going to obviously stuff it and everything. So what I need you to do is, and when you are finished with making the green parts and these yellow parts, let's start sewing this all together, and then we can go on to making the other embellishments. Okay, so let's first sew the corn together. So what I'm actually going to do, it really does not matter which side is your outside on here. So whichever side is coning outward, I guess, you can use as your outside. But what I'm going to do is put these two pieces together. Okay, I have my two short stragglers on one side and my two long stragglers on the other side. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull one on this side and one on this side. So this long one is going to sew down this side, and this long one is going to sew down this side. If you don't want it to be like that, you can just take one of these and sew around the whole thing. Totally up to you, but that's just exactly what I'm going to do. So we are going to yarn the yarn needle with this long strand of yarn, and I'm going to just whip stitch around. So we're going to go from one side to the other side. Okay, and I'm just whip stitching. So we're just going to go back over through this side to the other side. Okay, and just pull. And again, so whip stitching is always going through the same side. So always on this side, going to this side. Okay, and then pull. So always on this side, okay? You want to make sure your stitches all line up so they don't look weird or uneven. And we're just whip stitching all around this piece. Now when there is like an inch or a little less than an inch left of space for sewing, we need to stuff this piece. So I'll sew around this whole piece and then I'll meet you up when I have just a little bit of space left. We'll stuff it and then we'll close it all up. Alright, so I have just a little bit of space left, and you know what I actually was thinking about is that maybe I would turn this inside out, because the seam is kind of obnoxious for me. I don't know. It's like, if you don't want to turn this inside out, you don't have to, but I kind of feel like I'm not really a big fan of this, and if I turn it inside out, that will kind of be hidden. So I'm going to turn this inside out just to see. And it might look more like corn, too. So, see, you can't really even see the seam. Like, where is it? Oh, you really have to search for it. It's, like, right there. So, I'm going to turn it inside out. And then I'm going to stuff this piece here. Let me go in here. There we go. Okay. So, I'm going to stuff this piece now. And then I'm just going to sew this little tiny bit out on the outside, okay? But we want to make sure all the stragglers are on the inside. Again, you're not going to see those, so it doesn't really matter, you know, that those are on the inside and you didn't sew them in into the stitches to hide them. And now I'm just shoving a bunch of polyfill on the inside of this and kind of shaping it to be looking like an ear of corn, okay? And then I'm going to sew this all up and finish this part. Cute! How cute is that? Okay, then we're going to just continue working this. Just whip stitching this across here. And then once I'm, well, you know what? You can just continue watching because I'm going to show you how to fasten off. Because we have to tie a knot. So let me just get underneath these stitches here. Sorry. There we go. Okay, so when we're at the top here and we want to fasten this off, we're going to go underneath some stitches, okay? And then I'm going to keep my finger in this loop here when I pull this, and then I'm going to come back around through that loop, okay, and pull that tight and remove my finger, and that's tied off, okay? So there is what your corn should look like, and then we are going to put this on the inside here. Just shove it right on through. And then cut any extra. And then stretch it out. Again, make it look like corn. Well, it doesn't really look like corn right now even, but close enough. So now we're going to add these little leaf things. Look at that. Now it's going to look like corn. How exciting. So now we're going to sew these leaf things together. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to set this piece aside, grab my yarn needle, and then take a long strand of one of these leaves here. Okay. I'm going to take that and I'm going to put it, we're going to kind of just whip stitch these two together only halfway up the leaves. So I'm just going to go up this way, just like this. And this doesn't have to be super perfect because we're not, you know, stuffing this or doing much of anything with it. It's just going to wrap around the corn. So I'm just going to do a little bit of a faster job on camera here. But you can take your time with it, you know, make it however you would like it to. Just whip stitch this. Okay, and once you get to about the halfway mark, we can fasten that off. Okay, so to fasten this off, again, go through two or three of the stitches just like this. Pull that through, pull your finger in that loop, come back through, and then pull tight. Remove your finger, and there you go. Okay, so then there's what it looks like. Awesome. So now we can sew in this end here underneath some of these stitches. Cut any extra, stretch it out, and that's hidden. So now grab the other leaf. You should have three leaves in total here. So let me grab my yarn needle, this straggler here, just like that. Position this one next to this one, and then whip stitch this halfway. And then what we're going to do is take these two here and whip stitch these two. So then you're kind of making like a little pod for your corn to sit in. So I'm just going to do that, and then once I have these three all sewn together, we will go on to the next step. Alright, so I just had to sew in a few of the loose ends that were at the tops of these leaves here. So now I am going to cut that. And now what I'm going to actually do, so I sewed all this together here, these three little sections, and this is what your piece should look like. What I'm actually going to do is turn this inside out, kind of like how I did the corn part, just to make it the seams look a less, like more invisible, I guess. So there's that. So this is what it should sort of look like. So now you can stick your corn in there, and it actually looks like corn. How cute is that? So now I just want to add a few more embellishments. So what we have to do is make some eyes. This is optional though, otherwise you have your corn here and you can be done. But we want to add some eyes, so grab some white yarn and your hook. Make a slip knot. I showed you already how to do that. And we are going to chain two. So yarn over and pull through one and two. And then we're going to put six single crochets in that second chain from the hook. So go into there, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. So that's a single crochet. So one, go back in for two, go back in for three, You can see I'm working in a circular form as well. Five, and last one here, six. Then I'm going to count back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and go into this first single crochet and slip stitch. So yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And then we can fasten off, so chain one, and then cut the yarn kind of long for sewing, and then pull that all the way through and pull tight, okay? Now, for the other eye, just rewind this and make one exactly the same way as that. And I'm just gonna, this hole in the middle here, I'm just gonna close with this little straggler here. So while you're making your next one, I'm just going to sew this closed. Okay. Unless you have, if you have safety eyes, you can add safety eyes, or if you have like felt, if you have white felt, you can cut some circles out of felt, because I'm cutting actually the pupils for these eyes out of felt. So I'm just going to do that. There we go. So that center is closed. So make sure you make two of these. So that's what I have here. Let me grab my other one. There we go. So I have two of those. Grab your corn. Okay. And on the side here where you want the eyes to be, let's sew these on. So I'm going to put them right here. Okay, so grab that yarn needle, yarn your needle with that straggler we just cut. Okay, and then we're going to go in and out of this piece. Just going, you have to go through both layers there. It might get difficult, but there we go. Pull it through and go through the next stitch. You just want to make sure that these get sewn on nice and secure. That looks good. And then when you want to fasten this off, let me just go through two more stitches and I can show you how to do that. But it's exactly the same as we did earlier when we were sewing up the seams. Okay, so we're going to go through two of the stitches here. And then, whoops, I didn't put my finger in that loop. That loop right there. Just go back through that loop and then pull tight. And if you do have this straggler out too, you can go to the back of your work here and tie these two in a knot as well. And then shove these two stragglers to the inside. I'm just going to take my hook on the opposite end here and then go in from under here. There we go. Hook that on. Pull it through. If that works. Or, well, that didn't really work very well. That would happen because I'm on camera. I'm going to just take my yarn needle and just yarn this through here. There we go. So shove those inside, pull that through. Okay. I won't make you watch me sew the other eye on. So I'm just going to sew this other eye right next to this other one right here. Okay. Once I have that one sewn on, I will show you I'm going to glue on some felt for the pupils and the mouth, and then we'll go on to the very last step. All right, so I just sewed on these two white pieces for the eyes. So now we want to just glue on some felt pieces. I just cut these little felt circles for eyes. They look so cute. So I'm just going to take some tacky glue here and just glue that eye on. Whew. Just like that. And this other eye. Okay. And then I also have a mouth that I cut out of felt, just the same type, just like a half circle style. And we are going to sew that, or I'm sorry, glue that on also. Oops, that's a lot of glue. Get crafty. There we go. Okay. So there is the face. Okay, and that glue will dry clear, so I don't really have to worry about that. Okay, and then last thing I want to do, since this is an ear of corn, I grabbed some few strands of off-white colored yarn. Actually, I'm just going to take two strands here. And I'm going to grab my hook, go through the top of this, of its head here, just like that, from the back to the front. And then I'm going to hook on two strands of this yarn and pull it through. Okay. And then, I'm not going to pull it through all the way, I'm just going to loop it like that. And then, I'm going to go back and hook these four strands and pull those through. Okay, just like that. Then, what I'm going to do is take my yarn needle and go in between the ply, just like this, and kind of stretch it, or I guess separate these strands, just like this. And I'm gonna make some funky hair that looks like how it does on an actual piece of corn, an actual ear of corn. So I'm gonna fray this out, that's what I was trying to say. Fray out this yarn. Okay, almost done. And then I'm gonna trim this down. So this is the very last step of this corn. Okay, so it's all frayed out, and then what we want to do is kind of separate it like this, and then take your scissors and very carefully just cut random strands at random lengths. Okay, so I'm going to cut this one short, I'm going to cut this one long, and maybe this one will cut the same size. Okay, and then kind of pull that out. Make it random. And give him a little haircut. There we go. Very random and cute. That's so funny! Okay. And then, lastly, we can put this in here. Just like that. And there he's peeking out. How flipping cute is this corn? Thank you so much for watching and learning how to make this adorable corn amigurumi. I had so much fun making it. I hope you did too. If you did make this, make sure to share a photo on the Facebook and on the Instagram and hashtag YarnUtopia so I can see your funny little corn pieces. How fun is this? You can make like a whole family, make them different colors or whatever. I don't know. It's going to be fun. So enjoy. Thanks so much for watching every single day. I will see you next time. Happy hooking!